y'all, Surf and Sapo here. Welcome to Sapo Knows Indoor Kitchen. That's where I'm cooking today. That's the name of the place on Facebook, alright? You can't really check in here, only I can check in here, but anyway. My wife just got off work, and I don't want her to have to come home and cook or nothing, but I wanted her to have something easy to eat, so I went to H-E-B. You know, I said H-E-B sucks yesterday. The only reason I said that this is Memorial Day weekend coming up, and the other H-E-Bs in East Texas have brisket on sale. But here in Corpus, it's $2.59 a pound, which I know some people say, well, that's cheap. Well, we're used to like 99 cents a pound or $1.59 a pound, something like that. Anyway, sorry, H-E-B, for saying that. It is what it is. We don't have anywhere else to go, folks. So, anyway, I went to H-E-B. All right. And what I bought was 2 pounds of shrimp from Bauer Shrimp Farm in Palacios, Texas. It's just up the road on the way to Portlavaca. And they have a shrimp farm. Anyway, these are head-on shrimp. That's what I want, the head-on, because the flavor's in the shrimp. And I got some Andouille sausage, some little red potatoes, fresh corn, six for a dollar right now, pretty good price, and one box of boil. So what am I going to do? I'm going to make a shrimp boil for my wife. Is that cool? I guess so. I'll probably end up wanting some, but I'm going to let her have all of it, and what she can't eat, then I know she's going to eat the shrimp first. My wife was born in Aransas Pass. That was the shrimp capital of the Gulf Coast at one time when Gulf King was in its heyday. I don't know if y'all remember that, but Gulf King, they had a fleet, man. All Con Brown Harbor was just packed with shrimp boats. And I mean, shrimp galore. Now no more because of the feds, all the rules, but that's the way it is. Anyway, that's what we're going to do. Let's get started. All right, first thing you got to do is make a roux. Oh, wait, no, that's another recipe. I'm reading the wrong piece of paper. Hold on. First thing you got to do is wash everything. Take all your vegetables to the sink and wash them. So I'm not going to show you that, but I will chop some corn for you. Remember, we did this the other day. Y'all remember, right? I'm going to make them about that size right there. Alright? You can leave those on if you want, but I'm going to take them off. This right here, that's for lazy. Plus those worms in there. Adds more protein. Remember the little children of the corn little doll? I'll just start selling those on eBay. All right, let me do these. We'll get the Andouille sausage out. And I'm already boiling the water over there. I got this real nice pot from Kohl's when it opened up. It's got a steam, it's all stainless steel, heavy duty with a thick bottom. It heats up evenly. And it's got baskets. I use it to steam tamales too. So anyway, we'll worry about that in a minute. Oh, I wanted to show y'all something. JB Foods. That's funny, right? Anyway, we just cut these Andouilles open. They're not from Louisiana, but these are good, man. They're good. They were just bite size, you know? Not too big. Where you could just grab it, pop it in your mouth, and eat it. Not like that. And I'm putting all this in there. Let me do the other one. I got the corn and the potatoes ready. I'm just bringing the water up to temp. I'll throw this boil in. And we'll do the potatoes and the corn and the andouille first. Andouille is virtually cooked. You could eat it like this if you want. That's a good texture, man. A lot of marbling. Remember the little box, 99 cents? Old school, folks, old school. This is the what I've been looking for, the little bags of spices. You just chuck them in. Then you add your salt to that. That you don't even really need to add salt. You just put some Cajun seasoning. In fact, don't ever forget, Crazy About Crawfish Cajun Cafe. I'm just going to sprinkle this on the boil when it's done. I don't need to boil in salt. That's just me. That's the way I do it. That's the way I was raised to do it. Salt's good, but you can add, you can OD on it, man. You know? This way, the people can put salt as much as they want. And it's not overbearing. Because when you cook for a crowd of two people, you and your wife, you got to make sure you get it right. Or you might be in the doghouse. Be back. Alright, here we have the rolling thunder, the boiling. I can just dump these in, or I can just drop them in, however I want. What I can do is lift this up. It's got holes all in it. You can lift it up like so. Can y'all see that? And then I can just drop these in like this. Be safe. I'm gonna splash that boiling hot water on me. Cook these first, remember, because taters cook faster than shrimp. And you can put the lid on. That'll actually help a lot. It'll keep the steam in here. I got this. This thing's cool. It's got a little hole in it. Keeps the pressure on the food. So let me finish that, and then we'll drop in the andouille and the shrimps. Pretty fast, man. And crawfish are $2 a pound right now, but you got to buy a 35 pound sack, and they're fresh from Louisiana, but I don't have enough of people right now. It's a short notice, let's say. Anyway, whatever. I was going to show you something kind of cool. You can take this lid off, and you can actually set this in like that with the shrimp in there, and just let them steam a little bit at first. Okay, they're just going to steam. I'm not going to overcook them, and then I'm going to put them in the water and not even boil them. Just let them soak up in that boil. Alright? Alright, folks. The corn and the potatoes should be done by now. So I'm going to simply take this with the shrimp and the andouille and just let it fall in there. Okay, there we go. And if you can see, I don't know, can y'all see? Let's get a zoomer in on this. It's gonna come back up to a boil here in a sec. Get everybody underneath. Oh yeah. And little shrimps are already changing color fast. They could. I don't even boil shrimp, really. I just throw it in hot water. As soon as that hits a boil, I'm shutting it off. Because you can overcook shrimp and it's horrible. Okay, we bring it up to a boil. Shut it off. Just shut it off. These cook fast, man. I mean, shrimp cooks fast. I'd rather eat it raw than overcooked, where it sticks to the shell. That sucks, man, when it does that. Anyway, that's looking pretty doggone good, folks. Let me get you more in there. What do y'all think? Is that beautiful? Texas farm raised shrimp out of Palacios. I'm gonna have to go drive over there. That's not very far. Get an ice chest full of shrimp. I don't know what other sizes they have. Alright, next stop, we're gonna test it. I just wanted to show y'all, you can pull this out, tilt it, and it drains just like the way Joe and JB and Space Cowboy were doing it over there. But it's more manageable for one person. This is just a meal. Just me and my wife, you know. So actually, I'm gonna give her all. She gets all this, man. I'm gonna treat her like a queen, cook for her, and you know, you don't get married for nothing. And this June is our 25th wedding anniversary, so pray for us. All right, we're done. What I've done, they're still pretty hot, so I took a little bit off and just put it on this plate. This is how we do it, okay, at the household of Sapo. House of Sapo. Anyway, I tightened it up with this, the crawfish, Crazy About Crawfish, Cajun Cafe, Crazy Cajun seasoning. Kind of a tongue twister, actually, but dude, man, it's good. Anyway, shrimp, they're little, but they look little, but you know what? Bigger than a crawfish tail. Good. Little piece of andouille. It's all good. That's killer. Red potato. Perfect. And last but not least, a piece of fresh corn from local farmer John's. Good. I think I'll have another shrimp. Good meal, and it's actually healthy. Very little carbs except for the corn and the potatoes. But those are good carbohydrates, okay? It's not like flour. So anyway, somebody's coming and the dogs are fixing to bark, so I gots to go. Y'all take care now. Be on the lookout for another video. Bye. Oh, I'm back. I wanted to just show you. This is the plate I made for my wife. Isn't that lovely? Stacked with shrimp and andouille, with corn and red potatoes. This is a good meal. I mean, that's not even half of it. So she's going to eat good tonight. Remember, she's born in Aransas Pass. All right? That's the shrimp capital of the United States back in the day. Anyway, God bless. Bye-bye.